Welcome to the ISSS tutorial for STEM OPT. This video is to give some tips about how to fill in the I-983 form for your STEM OPT application. For overall STEM information, see the ISSS website. Section 1, Student Information. Student Name. List your name as it appears on your I-20. Student email address. Use an email address that will be valid for the next 2 years. Name of school recommending STEM OPT. This will always be the University of Pennsylvania. Name of school where the STEM degree was earned. This will almost always be Penn. There are some cases where your STEM extension could be based on a prior degree from a different school. For example, student received a bachelor's in science and chemistry at Drexel. The student then completes an MBA at Penn. The student receives 12 months of post-completion OPT based on their MBA. When the student approaches the end of their 12-month OPT based on the MBA, the student can then apply for a 24-month STEM OPT extension based on the prior bachelor's in chemistry, as long as the STEM OPT qualifying job is directly related to chemistry. In this example, the student would list the name of the school that conferred the STEM degree, in this case, Drexel. CVIS school code. This is found on your I-20. DSO field. This field must include the name, address, phone number, and email of your assigned ISS advisor, or DSO. Your assigned ISS advisor's name and email can be found when you log into IPEN. The address and the phone number is shown here for your reference. You may need to handwrite this section to be able to fit all the information into the box. CVIS ID. You should use the CVIS ID found on your I-20. STEM OPT requested period. The start date will be 1 day after the end of your current OPT authorization, and the end date will be 2 years later. Qualifying major and SIP code. Enter your major and SIP code as found on your I-20. The name of your major on your I-20 may differ from the name of your major at Penn. Use the information on your I-20. Level, type of qualifying degree. Enter the academic level upon which you are basing STEM OPT. For example, bachelor's, master's, or PhD. Date awarded. Date STEM degree was conferred. Use the degree awarded date as listed on your transcript. Penn degrees are usually awarded in May, August, or December, based on a prior degree. For most students, the answer will be no. If you are using a prior degree, for example, MBA graduate applying for a STEM extension based on an undergraduate chemistry degree, then you should click Yes for prior degree. If you are applying for STEM based on a prior degree, this degree must have been awarded by a U.S. school within the past 10 years. Employment authorization number. This is listed as the USCIS number on your EAD card. Section 2, Student Certification. Please sign the form in English. Do not use an electronic signature. Section 3, Employer Information. This section should be completed by your employer. Employer Name. Enter the name of your company or employer. Street address. Enter the employer or company mailing address. This may differ from your worksite address. Employer website URL. Enter the employer website URL, if available. If no website exists, enter NA. Employer ID number, or EIN. You must obtain this number from your employer. This is a 9-digit number. Number of full-time employees in the U.S. Obtain this from your employer. North American Industry Classification System, NAICS code. Obtain this from your employer. This is a 6-digit number. NAICS codes are accessible at this link. OPT hours per week. Enter the number of hours that you will work per week. In order to qualify for STEM OPT, you must work a minimum of 20 hours per week. Start date of employment. This is the start of the STEM OPT employment period. This date will be the same as the start date listed in Section 1. Compensation. Salary amount and frequency. Enter the dollar amount of salary, stipend, and/or other compensation and the frequency of pay, per hour, per week, biweekly, monthly. For example, $100,000 a year, paid monthly. Other compensation. Type an estimated amount or value. Other compensation may include housing, tuition waivers, transportation costs, etc. Section 4. Employer certification. Work with your employer to choose the proper person to sign this portion of the I-983 form. It could be an HR representative or your direct supervisor, etc. Section 5. Training plan for STEM OPT students. Student name. Enter your name as it appears on your I-20. Employer name. This is the name of the company or institution you work for, not your supervisor. Site name. Enter the employer's site name, which is likely to be the same as the employer name in Section 3. However, if you are working for a branch or subsidiary of a large entity or anywhere other than the headquarters, provide the name of this worksite. Site address. Enter the exact address of the worksite where the STEM OPT will take place. This may or may not be the same as the employer address listed in Section 3. Name of official. Enter the name of the appropriate individual in the employer's organization who is familiar with and will monitor your goals and performance. Also, enter this person's title, email, and phone number. This may or may not be the same employer official as in Section 4. The training plan should be completed by your employer and address all questions completely. ISSS cannot advise how to complete this section. Please refer to the I-983 instructions and/or the Study in the States STEM OPT Hub for guidance. Section 6, Employer Official Certification. Certification of Official with Signatory Authority. An employee with signatory authority for the employer should review the certification and affirm the statement with their signature. Please note, the individual who signs this certification can be, but does not have to be, the same individual who signed the employer certification in Section 4. Evaluation on student progress. These evaluations are not to be completed with the initial I-983 form. You should complete the first evaluation within 1 year of your STEM OPT employment. For example, if your STEM OPT started on June 20th, 2016, your first evaluation would be due to ISSS by June 20th, 2017. The second evaluation is due at the completion of your STEM OPT period and/or at the time of termination of employment, whichever comes first. please see the ISSS STEM OPT reporting website for up-to-date information on how to submit the evaluations in IPEN. This concludes the Form I-983 tutorial. Good luck with your application.